is my favorite way to create custom textures and use them in Adobe Illustrator. So what we're going to be using today is bitmap textures. What I love about bitmap textures is that it allows you to work within a set color palette. This is super important when you're working with a client or just on a project where you don't want to have lots of different colors going on and you've got a really limited set palette. So to help you get started, I've prepared a demo file. There's a link to this file in the description box below, so make sure you download before you watch the next bit of the video so you can follow along together. So we're going to start off with a blank document in Adobe Photoshop. From there, we're going to go up to the brushes panel and select. For me, I chose a blank brush, but you can choose any brush that you like. Then for this tutorial, I'm just going to draw a straight line with the feathered brush just to give you a nice gradient. Don't feel constrained to this though, feel free to try whatever shapes and styles that you like. So now we're going to turn this simple gradient into the texture. So we're going to go image mode grayscale and then image mode bitmap. You can leave these settings how they are, and then we're going to go file, save as, and select the TIFF option from the format function. You choose where to save the file, it's up to you. Leave these settings how they are as well. Then open up your demo file and drag and drop the texture into the file. If you get a pop-up warning like this, just click OK and progress from there. So now we've got our bitmap texture into our Adobe Illustrator file. Have a go with changing the color from the swatches panel. Having the flexibility to work within a set range of colors can be really, really beneficial, particularly when you're working with a client who might have brand guidelines that have a limited palette range. So our next step will be to come down to the layers panel, and we're going to move our texture down onto the texture here layer. You can go ahead and delete the blank layer. You should now see your texture on the texture here layer. As you can see, if you hide the outlines, we've got this pink section. This pink section is going to be our clipping mask. So what we're going to do is move the clipping mask above the outlines. We're going to select the texture that we want and the section of the clipping mask that we want. Once you've got both those selected, we're going to right click and go down to clipping mask. This will bound the texture into that area so that it clips to the appropriate section of the artwork. With your direct selection tool, you can move around the texture inside the clipping mask as well as change the color. You can even shrink and rotate this. Having the ability to move around and edit these textures is so useful. It means that nothing's destructive and you can always come back and change things later. Now I'm going to repeat this process for the rest of the artwork. You can do so as you wish, change the colors, have a play around with different textures and see what works for you. I'm simply repeating the same steps as before, making sure the texture is underneath the clipping masks, selecting both and then choosing clipping mask. At this point, it's a great opportunity to try different textures and see what works for your design. As you can see, we can still go in and change the colors or move the shapes around if we want to. If your chosen artwork doesn't have outlines, you can follow these same steps and the texture will simply bound to the shapes. I'd love to hear what you thought about the bitmap texture effect, so let me know in the comments below. I've also included a link in the description box for more productivity tips around Adobe Creative Cloud. Thanks!